All right, now that your installation is complete, your MultiPRO system must go through a startup sequence also known as debugging. I'd like to walk you through the step-by-step process to ensure proper operation of the MultiPRO system. So why do we have debugging? Among other things, this process helps the system determine how much refrigerant piping has been installed and ensures proper operation. Before beginning, double-check that a pressure test has been performed, the system has been evacuated to below 500 microns, and that the additional refrigerant charge was weighed in. Also ensure that the service valves are open on the outdoor unit and that the power has been applied to the outdoor unit for the recommended 8 hours. If you have a C model, as indicated by the model number ending in WLCTU, you'll perform the following steps. Access the control board of the outdoor unit by removing the top cover. There you'll find a two-digit display and four buttons labeled SW1 through SW4. This display should read AO, as should all indoor units and wired controllers. Press and hold SW3 for 5 seconds. Once you let go, the display will change. This display will show the step and the status of each step. Do nothing until 04 is displayed. 04 will display, and then the number of indoor units the outdoor unit sees will be displayed. If this number matches, press and release SW3. If the number doesn't match, check all the displays on the indoor units or wired controllers to find out which one is not communicating. The problem unit will display C0, meaning a communication error, or the unit may not have a display. On the unit without displays, check power. 05, 06, and 07 are internal communications checks. You'll do nothing. 08 indicates whether or not the crankcase heater has been on for 8 hours. If it hasn't, the unit will display 08 and then UO. You should wait until the minimum time has elapsed. If the power was on for 8 hours, the display will move on automatically. When 10 and on is displayed, the fan or fans and compressor will start. The system is checking that the service valves are open. When the display reads 12 and then AP and you needed to add remaining charge to the system, ready your scale, gauges, and refrigerant cylinder. If ready, or if no additional charge was needed, press and release SW3. The system will now display either 15 and then AC, meaning it will now run in cooling mode, or 16 and then AH, meaning that it will run in heating. The system chooses heating or cooling automatically based on ambient temperatures. If the system is starting in heating and you need to weigh in additional refrigerant, you'll wait until the debugging process is stopped, run the system in cooling, and then weigh in using the suction line. The system will run for 45 minutes to an hour. On your C model, you may notice that some indoor units start before others. This is normal. Once debugging is complete, the system will shut down. Simply turn the indoor units on in the desired mode. Thanks for watching. At GREE, we're by your side.